So I was in the dean's office as the dean of student affairs, and down the hall was one Arnold P. Gold. And he had a patient whose father was very grateful for having helped his son and gave Arnold a donation and said, I don't care what you do with it, but do something good. So Arnold said, you know, we had a lot of conversations up and down the hall, and he said, I'm not quite sure what to do. I just came from a meeting, the school consortium. We were having one of these fall meetings, and the dean of students at University of Chicago was Norma Wagner. And she said, you know, God, the students, first year students come in and they're so grubby and dirty. She said, I finally decided we should sort of clean them up, so we gave them all a white coat. So I was telling Arnold Gold this story, and he said, oh, what a great idea. And I said, why don't we try having this thing called the white coat ceremony the day before they actually start medical school. It was really just, you know, this is what we're going to do. We should have it in the alumni auditorium. All of the parents, all the families are invited. We'll read off their names and they'll come up and get their white coat. And then they're all asked to stand and they recite the Hippocratic Oath together with the people who are on the stage. And everybody stands for that. And that's also impetus for the white coat ceremony. Arnold was at graduation and heard the Hippocratic Oath being spoken by the graduates after they got their MD degree. And he said, you know, they really should say that at the beginning of medical school.
I do solemnly swear that whatever each of us holds will be sacred, that I will be loyal to the profession of medicine, just and generous to its members, that I will lead my life and practice my art in uprightness and honor.
And then there was a big, lot of applause. It's very moving. It's such a rite of passage. It shows that there's a humanism and humanity in medicine with the white coat ceremony. And it really is about patients. I mean, that's what it's about.
I was in the first white coat ceremony here at PNS in 1993. First white coat ceremony in the country, I'm proud to say. I'm an associate professor of medicine here at Columbia. And I'm a course director for the medical students. The white coat ceremony is sort of like, it's showtime, and we're all in this together. I am seeing the new recruits, and I want to see their faces when they get cloaked. And I want to participate in the Hippocratic Oath with them, because these are my colleagues. Now they're my colleagues.
My white coat ceremony was definitely a little surreal. To finally be at Columbia, at the place I wanted to be, getting the privilege of wearing that coat and knowing that I was trained to be a doctor for the next 4 years, I can't really describe it. It was exciting, it's a little bit intimidating, but it was amazing.
Something that was discussed during the white coat ceremony was how we were entering this profession that had a lot of responsibility towards others and how that was going to be a really big change from being a person who didn't have that to being a person now who had this opportunity really to care for the people we care for and also to kind of uphold the traditions of our profession in the best way possible.
Now, I think the important thing is that it's really introduction to medicine. And I think that was Arnold's point, is it should be done at the beginning of medical school to allow these young people to realize what a privilege it is to take care of patients. It really is a patient relationship that's created with the white coat.